Hello everyone, I am Sanjeev Pandey and today this is video 5 on the chapter The Tiger King written by Kalki. Let us start. The British officer's secretary sent word to the Maharaja through the Diwan that the Durai himself did not have to kill the tiger. See, the British officer's secretary sent word means message. The British officer secretary sent message to the Maharaja through the Diwan that the Durai, actually Durai is a Tamil word and this word has been used for the British officer. Through the Diwan that the Durai means the British officer himself did not have to kill the tiger. In that message it was conveyed that Durai, the British officer himself, did not have to kill the tiger. The Maharaja could do the actual, means real hunt, killing, real hunting. The Maharaja could do the actual, means the real killing, means hunting. What was important to Durai, means the British officer, was a photograph of himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. What was important to the Durai was a photograph. Actually, photograph was important for the British officer of himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. Actually, for the British officer, the photograph in which he was holding the gun and standing over the dead body of the tiger was important. But the Maharaja would not agree even to this proposal. If he relented means became soft. Now, if he became soft in giving permission, then what would happen? Then the other British officers would come for tiger hunting. If he relented means became soft now, means at this time, what would he do if other British officers turned up, means came for tiger hunting? Because he prevented a British officer from fulfilling his desire, the Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom itself. Because he stopped a British officer from fulfilling his desire. What desire? To hunt tiger. Because he had stopped a British officer from fulfilling his desire to hunt tigers. That's why his kingdom came in danger. He came in danger of losing his kingdom. See, the Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom itself. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberation, means discussions. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberations, means discussions over this issue. As a result, a telegram was dispatched. This means sent. As a result, a telegram was sent forthwith means without delay, at once, to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta. As a result, a telegram was sent forthwith means without delay, to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta. And what was written in the telegram? You see, send samples of expensive, means costly, diamond rings of different design. Send, this was written in the telegram, send samples of extremely costly diamond rings of different designs. Some 50 rings arrived. The Maharaja sent the whole lot, whole package, to the British officer's good lady. Good lady means the wife of the British officer. The Maharaja sent the whole lot, the whole package means all the 50 rings. He sent all the 50 rings. The Maharaja sent the whole lot to the British officer's good lady, his wife. The king and the minister expected the Duraisani to choose one or two rings. They expected that Duraisani means the British officer's wife. The British officer's wife would choose one or two rings and send the rest back and would send the remaining rings back. Within no time at all, the Duraisani sent her reply. The Duraisani means the British officer's wife sent her reply. And see what was written? Thank you. She thanked. Thank you very much for your gifts. Mean to say that she kept all the rings sent by the Maharaja. In 2 days, a bill of 3 lakh of rupees came from the British jewelers. In 2 days, a bill for 3 lakh of rupees came from the British jewelers. The Maharaja was happy that though he had lost 3 lakh of rupees, he had managed to retain, to hold his kingdom in his hands, and he did not lose his kingdom, because now the British officer's wife was happy and the kingdom of the Maharaja was safe in his hands. The Maharaja's tiger hunting continued to be highly successful. Now, the hunting of tigers by the Maharaja was a great success. See the light. The Maharaja's tiger hunts continued to be highly, means very much successful. Within 10 years, he was able to kill 70 tigers. And within 10 years, he killed 70 tigers. Within 10 years, he was able to kill 70 tigers. And then unforeseen hurdle brought his mission to a standstill. See the line. Unexpected hurdle means obstacle brought his mission. What was his mission? His mission was to kill 100 tigers. So this unexpected unexpected obstacle brought his mission to kill 100 tigers to a standstill, means dead end. Standstill means dead end. Now his mission to kill 100 tigers came to an end, because there were no tigers left in Pratibandhapuram. The tiger population became extinct in the forest of Pratibandhapuram. because the tiger population became extinct. There were no tigers left in the forest, in the forests of Pratibandhapuram. Who knows whether the tigers practice birth control or committed harakiri or simply ran away from the state because they desire to be shot by British hands alone. Who knows? Who knows whether the tigers practiced birth control? Who knows that tiger had started using birth control devices and that's why their population was extinct? Or committed harakiri suicide? Or they had committed suicide? Who knows? Or simply ran away? Or they ran away from the state because the tiger desired to be shot by British and alone means only. These were guesses about the decreasing population of the tigers in the forests of Pratibandhapuram. One day Maharaja sent for, means called the Diwan. One day the Maharaja sent for the Diwan and said, "Diwan Sahab, aren't you aware of the fact that 30 tigers still remain to be shot down by this gun of mine?" The Maharaja told the Diwan that there were still 30 tigers left to be killed by him with the gun. Maharaja asked brandishing, moving to and fro his gun, shuddering at the sight of the gun. Suddenly shivering of seeing the gun being brandished in the hands of the Maharaja, the Diwan became afraid. He started shivering. Suddenly shivering at the sight of the gun, the Diwan cried out, "Your Majesty, Maharaj, I am not a tiger. Maharaj, I am not a tiger. Why are you showing me this gun? Which idiot would call you a tiger?" The king answered, "Which idiot means nobody would call you a tiger. You are not a tiger." "Which idiot?" The king asked, "Which idiot would call you a tiger?" "No, I am not a gun. Now the king said, "You are neither tiger nor gun. Diwan Sahab, I summoned you, I called you here for a different purpose. I have decided to get married." Now the king said that he had decided to get married. See, actually Diwan was too much nervous, and in nervousness he started talking in foolish way. The Diwan began to babble, means began to talk foolishly, in foolish manner. "Your Majesty, I have two wives already. If I marry you, then what will happen to my wives? If I have two wives already, if I marry you, what will happen to my wives?" he wanted to say. "Don't talk nonsense. Why should I marry you?" The king scolded him and ordered him not to talk nonsense. "Why should I marry you?" And he asked, "Why should he marry him? What I want is a tiger. What I want is a tiger." He told him that he wanted only tiger. Thank you. Have a nice day.